It was the Go Home Show for SummerSlam, Friday Night SmackDown, but honestly, if I was going, I'd have probably just stayed home.
Yep, I would have stayed home, guys. I wouldn't have left the house. I'd have put padlocks over the door. I would have padlocked the basement, because that's where Dave Meltzer lives.
Dave Meltzer lives in the basement, probably watching this from his basement. Yeah.
Anyway, right. LA Knight kicks off this show, and he cuts a decent promo, and this is where the show died. Should just dedicate 2 hours. How good did the start of the show feel with LA Knight actually getting able time to cut a promo? I actually like him. It's actually good to see him cut a promo rather than just come out and get buried.
No, I like him too. Like, but it wasn't that good.
No, but he has something about him.
No, I like LA Knight. He definitely does. He reminds me of The Rock. He does. I'm not going to say he's a Rocky ripoff, but he certainly does remind me.
I said this weeks ago, right? No, oh, we're going to wait till after SummerSlam to push him. Why not Grayson Waller against LA Knight? Showcase them at fucking SummerSlam. Show what they've got against each other. Oh, but they're both... Oh, they're kind of tweeners, but Grayson Waller's more of a heel. Fuck it, geez it. Why not? Battle Royal, give us a fuck.
It's a Battle Royal Slim Jim. 25 men fighting for the pepperoni stick. I believe that's what a Slim Jim is, isn't it? It's a pepperoni.
I've never had a Slim Jim. Snap into a Slim Jim, yeah, oh yeah.
I think a Slim Jim is like a pepperoni stick that you can eat. I'm not entirely sure.
It is, but pepperoni's just better.
Somebody let us know down below in the comments, for you Yanks out there, what is a Slim Jim? But anyway, this
match sucked. Right?
This is your SmackDown review, so enough of Slim Jims. Let's get on to the match. So we got LA Knight running down his opponents, which is pretty good. He called Sheamus a big pasty white man. I said that Sheamus has been successful. Sheamus has won a lot of titles, but it's time for him to take his first loss to LA Knight. Yeah, and I don't get what Kevin Nash's fucking problem is. How everybody in wrestling can have an issue with this guy? A guy that is actually kind of entertaining and reminds you of The Rock. As if reminding you of The Rock is such a bad thing. Holy fuck. In an era where everyone sucks, everyone's got like vacuum charisma, like it's just been sucked out of them. No one's entertaining, no one stands out, no one looks like a star, no one has got the gift of the gab, no one can talk. In this era, Kevin Nash has got a problem with LA Knight.
Yeah.
I think it's jealousy. Kevin Nash fucking sucks, man, he does.
He's turning into
sexy, Kevin Nash.
Sorry to burst his bubble, right? And obviously it's sad his son died, but he's turned into a bitter bastard, isn't he? Depresso. I think.
I thought you were going to say he's turned into Bret Hart.
Yeah, well, that's pretty much what a bitter Depresso is, isn't it? It's Bret Hart.
I mean, if you want to sum up Bret Hart with Kevin Nash, I mean, I'd say Kevin Nash's career was 4 out of 10.
He never sold out Madison Square Garden.
I mean, Nash, let's be honest. I mean, come on, you were the lowest rating fucking drawing world champion ever in that era.
Numbers don't lie.
It's not like the Kevin Nash run. And I'm not going to bury Kevin Nash, but probably my favorite things for me, Kevin Nash's best moments, in my opinion, he's contributed to wrestling, has been when he does interviews half drunk.
Sipping on red wine, Costa Blanco.
No, that's my favourite Kevin Nash memories.
True.
It's not Kevin Nash promos or Kevin Nash matches. It's when Kevin Nash gets a wee glass of red wine and he sits down.
Oh, he pulls his core, that's pretty good.
And he lets the stories unfold. I like Kevin Nash, but I just don't understand why everybody...
No, there's something, there has to be something hidden that we don't know.
Is it because The Rock buried him that time? He doesn't like The Rock, therefore he doesn't like this guy who reminds him of The Rock.
It could be.
Could it just be that simple?
It could
simple?
Be as simple as that, man.
Oh, The Rock fucking owned. Big Daddy Cool, Diesel, You know, is it because The Rock
he's
done
a,
that?
He's a dick.
Is it because, yeah, it might be. That's the only reason I can think of why Kevin Nash wouldn't like LA Knight.
Just remember, anyway, paved the way for you guys. Fuck off.
I know Kevin Nash thinks when he came... Kevin Nash thinks in 2002 that The Rock should be bowing down to him. What kind of backwards ideology is that? I mean, seriously?
Yeah.
Fucking 2002, I mean, The Rock was halfway at the company and the guy was going to transcend into being the biggest fucking star in the world. I mean, the guy's going to go on to make all these massive movies.
Even at the end of 98, should The Rock be bowing down to Kevin Nash?
No, fuck. Even at 98, like, you could... In the fucking end of 97, you could tell The Rock was going to be one of the next big things.
Yeah.
He was heading to leadership of the nation. But anyway, let's as much as I would love to sit here and talk about Kevin Nash and 98 Rock, it's time to rock this SmackDown review.
This match was a mess. Every time I looked at my phone for about 90% of this match, but each time I looked up, there was a different fucking person in the ring.
Yeah, we had all the other jabronis, as The Rock would say. Very heavy Rock review, but we had our SmackDown review featuring The Rock. But we did have a lot of jabronis come down, and they were all around ringside. So basically, everybody that's going to be involved in the Slim Jim Battle Royal was out here for this match, and it was just, it was like a clusterfuck. People were getting involved, people were climbing the ring. LA Knight and Sheamus were falling off the top turnbuckle to the outside. In the end, LA Knight wins, he beats Sheamus. Which, I mean, I don't know if that's good for him, because normally if you win, I mean, before going into the pay-per-view, you don't win the pay-per-view. So, I don't know if this is good for LA Knight, but you know what, fuck it. Nice to see him actually not take a pinfall. And he beat Sheamus, who, let's be honest, is a pretty good win. If we're talking about wins,
yeah, but my
and losses, I think a win over Sheamus for LA Knight, it's better than what he's done in the past 3 months.
That's brilliant, right? My problem with this is, we have got faces in the ring celebrating with heels, like pointing at LA Knight, and it's what was that? What actually was? There was no structure to this.
You never see this, you never see this in wrestling. At the end, like when it's about the finish segment's about the finish, you've got like, is it Austin Fee? No, not Austin Fee. Who's that other guy?
Grayson Waller.
No, Karrion Kross. You've got Karrion Kross in the ring pointing at LA Knight with somebody standing behind Karrion Kross, and we. Santos Escobar on the other turnbuckle, and it's like, why is a heel and a face sharing the ring? Like, normally the one person would clear the ring, or you would get all the faces in the ring, or you get all the heels in the ring.
The ring, you've got AJ Styles and Scarlett Bordeaux looking at each other. You've got the Good Brothers fucking sitting watching from afar. Then you've got who was the other two jobbers? The Brawling Brutes are just sitting there looking at Sheamus. This is one of the most disjointed things I've ever seen in wrestling. It was that may be an over-exaggeration, but to me, it was a fucking mess.
It was a who's who of bums.
Yeah, I've never seen something like this before.
And not in a good way.
Like, it's not like LA Knight is like the common enemy and he's an outsider for WCW or TNA or something. He's just a guy. Why would they all unite against him?
Yeah, I didn't understand
it. Because he won the match.
Well, it's the only match he's won. Give him a fucking break. Let him get a victory.
Maybe Kevin Nash put out a fucking warrant for LA Knight's arrest or something. I don't know.
Maybe they're all trying to impress Big Sexy. Anyway, we go backstage. We have the Brawling Brutes and Sheamus. They're arguing with the club, the OC. Adam Pearce is trying to scream and break this up. He says, if you want to fight each other so much, then go and do it right now. Meet in the ring. And then we get an impromptu tag team match. We get the Brawling Brutes versus the OC. Maya Yim was with the OC. Does anybody care? I don't. Thoughts on this match? Street Profits come out, attack both guys, wearing suits. I guess this is the beginning of the formation of the new Hurt Business. And what I will say is, I don't think this is going to hurt the Street Profits, because the Street Profits are stale. I know it's sad, they've only been in wrestling like 3-4 years, but they've been stale for at least a couple of years now. I remember when they first debuted on the main show and they were doing like the commercial, like the news commercial things. I thought that was pretty entertaining.
But not the problem. No,
after a month, they dropped that. And WWE does that all the time. They'll bring somebody in. They'll have them maybe do some segments at the beginning, and then they'll completely drop the segments and just give you no reason to care about them other than wrestling matches.
WWE's problem is they're stagnant. See when wrestling was great. People evolved pretty quickly. Like the Dudleys, the Hardys, Edge and Christian, the APA, I'm sure there's other teams I'm missing out. They all split up within 5 years. See Sami Zayn and Kevin Owens, man. See, I've seen them scroll through YouTube. There's so many matches of them together. They both look the exact same. Same with Rollins. Like, these people just don't evolve. Like, see if you look at between 93 and 2001, that's 8 years. Look how much happened. See, from 2023 back to 2015, Kevin Owens is the same fat fuck he was then.
Yeah. It's thing he would say, LA Knight. But no, I mean, let's look at the APA, for example. It's not like they had two segments backstage back in the day where they were doing their their poker tournaments on the tables, drinking beers, and then you never seen it again. There was a continuous thing. I don't know why they did that with the Street Profits, where they were doing this whole, this news anchor thing, and then just completely drop it.
Yeah.
But whatever. We had a beatdown. Looks like the Street Profits are teaming up with Bobby Lashley.
Bobby.
What's wrong with Bobby? Is Bobby injured or have they got nothing for him?
The crowd were hot for Bobby.
I don't understand how the fuck we can have a brand split with two separate rosters and they're purposely keeping people like Bobby Lashley off the roster. Well, we don't really have anything for Bobby right now. Your show's fucking shit. What do you mean you have nothing for Bobby? Every available fucking star they have should be on SmackDown or should be on Raw.
Bobby, I know it should be, but see me like, oh, we're going to wait to push him to after summer. Why?
Because I forgot there's 10 million people in front of him at the moment getting great pushes that are getting great crowd reactions.
Like, how much better would it be if you scrapped this Battle Royal and gave us like two other meaningful fucking matches out of the people that's in it?
Well, I don't think they're going to do that because this is getting it's a promotional thing, so it's the Slim Jim, you know.
It's a promotion. Fuck off. Wait, I just like the Mountain Dew match, remember that? That belt of a match.
Yeah, LA Knight had a chance in that, and that was fucking shit. LA Knight doesn't do good in promotional matches. Anyway, up next, we got a video package, Charlotte Flair on the beach saying that she's a queen, she's this, she's that.
The sun is melting the plastic, oh god.
Yeah, put her in the recycling trash can. She says that there's a reason why she's 5-0 at SummerSlam. Flair says she's going to become champion again. She says that she has their number and they can't beat her. So, yeah. Woo! Just give me back Rick.
Yeah, give me 90-year-old Ricky.
I think it's sad though that we can't get Rick as a manager. Why the fuck can't they have Rick as Charlotte's manager?
They did for a bit in 2015, but he was done.
Well, I'd take him over with the... But he says that he can still go. They just took him off TV. They didn't trust him with the mic.
Because he looked like shit.
Could it have been that as well? Like, but remember back in the day, we had a shitload... I mean, back before we really were... Gorilla Monsoon, he looked like fucking dog shit.
I know.
Paul Bear. He looked like dog shit.
He looked like that guy that was making fun of Tony Soprano's fucking mental health
problems. Bobby Heenan never looked great.
Carmine, that's what he looks like.
Wrestling's had a history of having big fat guys on the outside.
What about Paul Heyman?
Paul Heyman? I could understand that if Ric Flair was female and they're like, hold on here. In the prime, she used to be this like fucking hot chick and now look at her. She's 75 years old or whatever. I could accept that, but I mean, like Ric Flair, like, doesn't matter if he looks old. He's still the nature fucking boy. He can still cut a promo.
Yeah.
I don't know why we can't have Ric Flair back.
Right, up next with Paul Heyman explaining the Tribal Chief rule match. Oh, out comes JSO. Nah, big man. Solo Sikoa. No. This is... I'm just sick of this. I really hope this is the end of it.
What do you mean the end of it? How does it end? If JSO loses, it doesn't end. And if JSO wins, it doesn't end. So I just don't see how the bloodline's ending at SummerSlam.
Right, but why is Roman Reigns not on this show? I mean, it's in the same arena as SummerSlam, I believe. Well, it's in the same city, at least. I know that much. So that tells me it is in the same arena. What's his excuse for not being here?
All this is done all Roman Reigns winning at last year's WrestleMania is done. It's dragged out the bloodline storyline even further than it had to. And it's just derailed Cody Rhodes. Should have just had Cody Rhodes win.
Yeah.
Could have just broke up the fucking bloodline. You could have had the Usos.
The bloodline do not need the belts, the feud.
Plus, why not have Roman Reigns lose, but have the Usos retain? And then it's fucking Roman Reigns that's lost the belts. And then when they done Roman versus Solo, they could have the belts on the line in that match. That match was big. If there was any match worthy of having tag team titles on the line, it was that match right there.
Yeah.
What's Kevin Owens and Sami Zayn doing at the moment? Fucking one of the worst runs possible. I know Kevin Owens is bitching about it, but at the end of the day, mate, you're Kevin fucking Owens. You're some fucking fat guy. Sami Zayn, outside of his like recent work with the bloodline and before that, the conspiracy theory thing, this guy's never worked in WWE. This guy's never got over or been popular, especially as a face. Are we all surprised now? I actually think Kevin Owens and Sami Zayn outside Rhea Ripley is one of my least favourite things in wrestling right now. Kevin Owens like, you can't be here, you can't do this, it's not your turn, it's our... Like, what's that?
Oh, that's Vince McMahon, apparently. That's what that is, according to JD.
Fucking shite.
I fucking despise Kevin Owens.
It's absolutely... I just bought this run, but... Man, I can't think of a worse tag team in WWE than Kevin Owens and Sami Zayn.
Yeah.
The run is fucking terrible.
The Creed are mutants, like, I'll give them that.
And we all know where it's leading to. It's leading to Kevin Owens turning on Sami.
Again?
How many times have we seen Kevin Owens and Sami do that thing where they grab each other around the back of the neck and do the fake punches? And we're going to see it again. You fucking know what's going to happen. Like,
well, you see Triple H, like, he didn't betray Shawn Michaels every 3 weeks, did he? He did it fucking once.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But yeah, it would have been lame if he fucking was betraying him all the time. Wouldn't have had the impact that it had. Anyway, Jesus will super kick the Soul Sikoa, tells Heyman, tell his cousin, you'll see him tomorrow, and tell his little brother, you'll see him tonight. Then Jay does some, like, breakdancing as he leaves the ring. Down, 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 down. Anyway, WWE Hall of Famer Rey Mysterio featured an injury or suffered an injury last week or whatever, so we have to find out if Rey Mysterio's going to be okay. His status is currently day-to-day. He's at home recovering severe whiplash.
Yep, car crash.
Car crash. Then we got Caleb Braxton with Austin Theory. He said he's not worried about facing Santos Escobar next week. He will dedicate the win to Rey Mysterio. Theory says, like Santos next week, tonight Cameron Grimes will have his dreams crushed as he experiences Austin Theory live. Up next, WWE Champion.
You want to talk about a guy that sucks? Austin Theory.
WWE United States Champion Austin Theory versus Cameron Grimes. I'm not going to sit here and pretend that it's only Austin Theory's title reign that sucks in WWE, because literally everyone fucking sucks. But this one is by far, maybe, I don't know if it's the worst, but it's up there. It's definitely close.
Yeah. This guy...
No, actually, it is the worst. It fucking is. I think it is the worst. At least I'll say Gunther puts on half-decent matches. I think Gunther's matches are pretty entertaining at pay-per-views.
Yeah, Austin Theory.
I mean, Austin Theory can't even get on the pay-per-view. The only way he gets on a pay-per-view is by facing Cena.
How can you have a match against Cena at Mania and it be the worst match of the night?
That was fucking... I don't care. Cena's old. Like, I mean, 90-year-old Cena should be able to get a good match out of you.
Cena's no, dropped just the ball recently. That match, Counter-Strike, come on, John.
No, but look at the match. Look at Cena's last match against Roman Reigns. And I get it, that was a while ago. But I mean, come on. You tell me in the space of 1 year, Cena's went from being able to put on a great match with Roman Reigns in the main event to that shite with Austin Theory. I'm not buying
what
that.
The tag team match he put on?
Kevin Owens, and even that was good. So yeah, I'm not blaming Cena here. I think it's Theory's fault. This United States title run is, it's either approaching 300 days or it's surpassed 300 days.
Yeah.
And it's fucking awful. I don't know what it is with WWE and long title reigns, but they need to stop it. Outside of Cena, you can't really mention anything memorable Austin Theory's done since beating Seth Rollins, I think it was.
Nothing at all.
And I believe one of his title defences was actually in the chamber.
Yeah.
And that chamber match is fucking garbage.
I mean, he does beat Cameron Grimes here, but who cares?
Cameron Grimes almost beat Theory early
Send
on.
Send Cameron Grimes to the fucking bin as well while you're at it.
Cameron Grimes!
He's from a small town. Are you allowed to say that, Cody? Or we're bad at small town. Try that in a small town.
Try that in a small town.
Can you try putting on a good fucking show in a small town, please?
I wouldn't mind a good show. Would you mind a good show?
No, of course I would.
Right, sum up Austin Theory's US title reign, because I've done a good enough job.
Shite.
Oh, there you go.
What is there to say? Like you said, he can't even get on the pay-per-view. I mean, the US title can't even get defended at fucking SummerSlam over, what, Shayna Baszler against Ronda Rousey?
Well, that's Ronda Rousey's last match, so fair enough.
Alright, well, shite matches happening. All of them.
Hold on here, you actually picked the one time fucking Shayna Baszler's in an interesting situation.
Interesting situation.
MMA rules, I'll take that.
MMA rules, it'll be a fucking fake match.
It might be real.
No, you wish. Oh, I was the fifth one to hold Rousey's baby. Fuck off, well, that's the feud.
The fifth?
Aye.
Fifth's no bad, actually, hold on. You've got the nurse. Then you probably have, like, the mother, father.
Yeah, then Rousey's mother held it, then she did. And she's marking out about it.
Peter, number five's no bad.
Number five's no bad. Aye, well, it's not going to be a five-star match.
Well, she's not held any titles in WWE, has she? So keep holding that baby.
Ugliest Bastard of the Year award, like, that's...
Oh, I don't know. I thought Shotzi was pushing her hard tonight. Like, anyway, Asuka cuts a anime promo to promote our Triple Threat match at SummerSlam. You know what's sad? I would say Asuka's probably got the most exciting title reign in WWE at the moment. And that's... that's like... Well, name me a better one.
Dirty Dom. I don't know.
I mean, maybe Dirty Dom's only had it like 2 weeks. Fuck me. Anyway, yeah. So we see. She said no one.
Family.
Had it 1 week. No one is ready for Asuka. And I was talking about main title runs.
Right, what did I say earlier about people remaining stagnant? Asuka's had the same character for the past 8 years.
Yeah, I mean, she can change up the makeup. She can change up the hairstyle. She can make the hair long. She can make the hair short. She can wear a mask. She can wear face paint. She can wear full face paint, half face paint. She can change up the attire. She can change up the boots. She can change up the colour of the mist. But at the end of the day, this has been the same Asuka, slightly tweaking the character. It doesn't change the actual character. It's been the same fucking Asuka for a long, long time.
It's the same as Charlotte, same Belair as well. Becky Lynch ever since she became the man. That's just the way it goes. No, look how stagnant the women are. Especially compared to, even though the men are incredibly...
Well, here, if you're good, there's nothing wrong with being stagnant, because no one really notices it, but yeah, if you're shit, then... If you're shit, you're shit, and this roster's shit.
But look at Taker. Like, within, like, 5 years, he's went for, like, Ministry, American Badass, Back to the Dead, man.
Well, let's not mention Taker in the same sentences as these people, because...
I'm just showing you, like, years... See, back in the day, so much happened within a year in wrestling. See, now, you look about 10 years ago, and Reigns was still 3 years into his fucking title reign.
I reckon you could realistically stop watching wrestling for a year and pick up again. And you wouldn't have missed much. Half the champions would still be the same.
Yeah.
Which is fucking insane.
Right, let's move on.
Yeah, let's move on. Up next, we had the Grayson Waller show. Grayson Waller didn't really get to say much. He says that, although he did say that just like, just as normal, one woman is not enough for Grayson Waller. So tonight, he's got two on his show. Out comes Bayley. Out comes Io Sky. Io Sky had trouble sitting on the chair. I don't know if the chair was too tall for her, but she couldn't get up on the Grayson Waller chair.
Was that a booster seat?
Yeah, maybe she needed a booster seat.
Aye.
So that happens. Bayley talks about them having the Money in the Bank briefcase, speaking as if she's Christian here on AEW. It's not hers, it's Solo's. It's, well, not Solo's, but it's a Solo briefcase that belongs to Io Sky, but Bayley marking it as if it's like some sort of team effort. Grayson Waller asks if she's going to cash it in tomorrow. Why would she say yes to that? She doesn't get to say anything. Bayley cuts her off. Then Shotzi's music plays. Bayley.
Did Jim speak English?
Yeah, it's broken. Just like this show.
It's broken.
Just like this company. The Shotzi music plays. Bayley is trying to leave, but then Grayson Waller's like, ha 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 ha, that was me, don't worry about it. Bayley gets in the ring and says, don't do that again. She also says that Ding Dong Hello is a better show than the Grayson Waller Effect, which I am going to disagree with. Then Shotzi's music goes again. Bayley thinks that Waller's trying to pull her leg. He's like, oh no, it wasn't me this time. Then we see the tank come out. Bayley panics. She sends Io Sky up to take on the tank. Turns out it is Selena Vega in the tank. And then behind Bayley, we get the returning Shotzi Blackheart, or Shotzi, she's called now. They've dropped the Blackheart. Is that because she doesn't have a Blackheart? Who knows?
Doesn't have any hair either.
But she's here with her new hair, her new locks, or lack of locks, should I say, and this just isn't a good look for Shotzi. I mean, I know why she done it, and respect to her for doing it, but I think when you fucking suck in the ring, and when you suck at promos, when you have a character that absolutely sucks, and there's not a lot that's redeemable about you, and from a wrestling standpoint, and you cut your hair to make you look less attractive, I don't think that is a good idea.
No.
But here, respect to the reason for why she did it.
Why did she do it?
Because her sister's got cancer.
Fair play to her then.
So, I mean, I respect that. But it's just, I mean, it wouldn't have made much sense. It'd be like, you know, Shawn Michaels, and back in the day, he's like, I'm just your sexy boy. If he cut his hair, you know, if he done the buzz cut in 95, like, I don't think it would have worked well for him. Even if he did it for good reason. I don't think it would have been a good look for Shawn Michaels.
Sure, Michaels hoovered the belt off Bulldog and his sister was dying of cancer.
Yeah, that was pretty poor, wasn't it? Did Michaels not refute? Was Bulldog not supposed to win that night? And Michaels kind of went slinging.
That's what I'm saying, he hoovered off.
Whoa. Now, Michaels, greatest of all time, in my opinion, when it comes to in-ring. But
not seeing a lot of sunny days, Davey.
Ah, well, I mean, if Bulldog challenged Michaels when he found God...
In the dog poop.
He might have given the belt back, but I think Bulldog was dead.
He was,
by the time Michaels found God, which kind of sucks.
Not a bit. Michaels found God, and he's like, Bulldog has to go, brother.
Bad timing there. Anyway, Selena Vega beats Io Sky. Don't know why, but she does. Then we get the main event, Jey Uso versus Solo Sikoa. Jey Uso beats Solo Sikoa, beats him clean. And I believe this is only the third time Solo Sikoa has lost a match clean since coming up to the main roster.
Mental, but I don't know. It just seems weird that Roman Reigns ain't here tonight to oversee this.
Oversee it?
Aye, be there. I mean, it's the last show, for fuck's sake. Why can't he be there? Like, what? Why? How many times are we going to see, like, the Jey Uso against Solo Sikoa, like, interact? It happens about 10 times a week. Not think so.
Aye, it does, but I mean, what do you expect?
Just a dead ending to the show, just like a review. I mean, what did this make me want to tune into SummerSlam?
I don't think anything could have happened tonight that would make me want to tune into SummerSlam.
No, definitely not, but we will anyway, won't we?
Unfortunately, we will. What I don't think helps is watching old wrestling. I think watching retro wrestling alongside current wrestling, I don't think it's good.
Especially when they're both in the build up to SummerSlam.
Yeah, because then you've got, just look at 2002, you've got Brock versus Rock, you've Michaels versus HBK, Michaels versus Triple H. I mean, you've got so much good shit going on, so much good angles, so many good stories and characters, and then, I mean, you look at wrestling today, and what have you got? You've got an absolute shit show. I mean, that's what this SmackDown was. I normally praise SmackDown, I normally say it's the best show of the week, it's better than Raw, but I mean, tonight SmackDown was very fucking poor, not a lot happened, started off okay with LA Knight, and after that, just went downhill. I'm going to get, I'll get a 1 for the opening LA Knight promo, but nothing else after that really did anything for me.
I agree with a 1, guys. It was poor. Literally, like I said at the beginning, went downhill from there.
Yeah.
Anyway, guys, that's it. SummerSlam later on tonight. Looking forward to it. Not really, but we'll check it anyway. I don't know what could happen on SummerSlam to make it great. Hopefully we get some title change. I don't know. Hopefully we get something big. Maybe a big return. Maybe Carlito can come back and hoover all the belts and then be a 10-time champion or something like that. Like in the game, you know, when the wee character held all the belts at the same time. Maybe something along those lines. Anyway, guys, that's it for Fog Wrestling. Thanks for watching. We'll catch you in the next one. Till then, peace.